Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name's David and this is Mentalism Week. Hey everybody, thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for joining me. Today we're starting Mentalism Week. That's right, Mentalism Week. That means all this week we're doing mentalism reviews, magic tricks. I review magic tricks, I review playing cards, and I do giveaways every single month. You like that kind of stuff, hit like, hit subscribe, hit the buttons, do the thing, check the boxes, do the YouTube, you know what to do. Today we're gonna look at a card merely thought of two from Molim El Barsh, and you can find this at penguinmagic.com. You can also find this at his website, wondersandmysteries.com. This is a download. That's right, this is a download. We're reviewing a download. I haven't reviewed a download in a while. Thought, you know what, it's about time. So you're not getting anything with this, right? It's a download. You can do this with just your deck of cards and the spectator's deck of cards. And this is a fantastic trick to do over Skype or Zoom. $20, you're gonna get an hour and 7 minutes of instruction. All right, a card merely thought of. That's right, a card merely thought of, not the book. Not the book from Thomas Baxter. Not that card merely thought of. this is a trick you can do. And I would just say, this is probably best over Skype or Zoom. Now you can do this in real life. You can, you absolutely can. It'll work pretty much almost the same way. But I would say this is gonna be stronger over Skype or Zoom. And really this is just the modern day version of a phone trick. You know, if you've got any of the old Animan stuff, you know that there was a whole series of tricks that you could do over the phone. You'd call somebody and you'd read their mind over the phone. And I don't know if you've ever done any of those types of tricks, or you do a type of trick where you're in another room, right? You're in another room. It's the same kind of plot, but now just modernized for the century that we live in, right? So being able to do a card trick over Skype, over Zoom, and like the title suggests, a card merely thought of. They're gonna have their own deck of cards. Now you could have one too, and you could do a do as I do type thing, just so that they're doing it correctly. But if you're really good at giving instruction, go for it. But they have their own deck. They have their own deck and they shuffle their own deck. Now there's a couple times where they're gonna show you the cards, obviously. But for the most part, the cards will be facing them. They will mentally select a card. Mentally select a card. There's even a point to where you will block the screen and turn away and not even look at the screen. And you will be able to tell them exactly what card they're thinking of. Of course, divining someone's only thought of card, especially over Skype, right, seems impossible. So let me read to you some of the ad copy, the pros that are listed out for this trick. Obviously, a normal deck, no markings or anything like a marked deck. You're gonna use all 52 cards, of course. And you're gonna get a legit shuffle from the spectator. You won't even know the order of the cards. And all that's true because they're on the other side of the screen and they're using their own deck. So obviously they're not gonna use a marked deck. Obviously you're not gonna know the order. There's also no second screen or no app or anything needed on that end. And you're not hiding anything off screen. You could show your entire room to the spectator if you wanted. Plus you're also not gonna lead the spectator. You're not gonna have them, you know, pick a certain card or a certain area of cards, they're gonna get a completely free choice of any card they wanna think of. Plus, there's no anagrams, no counting, no math, and no heavy memorization work other than the routine. You will have to remember how the trick goes. Now, obviously, if there's an hour and 7 minutes of instruction, there's a lot to cover, right? There's a lot to cover. This is not a self-working trick at all. But since it is a download, obviously, you're not getting anything. Is it what I thought? I had no idea what method they were gonna use. But let me just say this, they're all classic elements of magic that you're probably already familiar with. Of course, there's no slights. There's no slights because they are doing all the work. What's the overall quality and production value of the video? There is no microphone. It's mostly a stationary shot. You're getting regular indoor lighting. This is a very low budget made video. As far as what he's gonna teach you, he's gonna show you what this looks like over video chat, and you will watch both screens with him and another gentleman. He's then gonna teach you the 007 peek, And of course, he's gonna run you through the entire trick, the entire routine, and teach you step by step how to do this. He'll do a second section where he'll change it up a little bit for a one-on-one. So if you are in the room with someone, you're gonna do this a little differently. Let's just say if you're using a computer, the computer is actually gonna help you. But of course, if you're doing a one-on-one, you don't have that advantage. So there's a little bit of a deck stack involved in this one. This one's taught on a table with an over-the-shoulder shot, and then there's an outro. Of course, there's no angles because the spectator's doing all the work, and like I said, there's no practice as far as card sleights go. Now, you will have to know how to do the trick, and you'll have to be familiar enough with the layout of your computer. Setup and reset, like I mentioned, computer. You can also do this with your phone. You can do this with your phone. I think it's gonna be harder to do with your phone just because you'll have to navigate getting around your phone at the same time as you're talking to somebody on the screen. So I think using a computer, using a PC is gonna be so much easier. Positives. Hey, in summary, this is a great mentalism effect that you can do over Skype, and it's easy and literally, right, requires no sleight of hand on your part. And it will end up looking like a miracle because how in the world, right? How in the world would you know what their card was? Negatives, all right, so what are the negatives? Like I said, the video is not that great. Even during the live performance, he had a slow connection speed where he couldn't even see the other guy, it was buffering. And he should have just reshot that instead of using that footage. And then the camera hardly even changes for the entire file. Like you're getting the same exact shot through the entire thing. And for an hour and 7 minutes, it was way too long. There should have been a little bit more editing on the video. Tighten it up. Like, make sure you know exactly what you want to say in the order that you want to say it. Tighten it up. To spend an hour and 7 minutes on it was probably too much. Is it worth your money, though? It's $20. $20. And so that's very affordable, especially if you're looking for another trick that you can do, especially a mentalism piece that you can do over Skype or Zoom. Reading minds over the internet? Awesome. But don't just take my word for it. Don't just take my word for it. There are other review channels out there that you should be watching. Make yourself aware. I do not want to be the lone wolf or the only voice in Magic Reviews. Please, there are other review channels out there. They're awesome. Definitely go subscribe and like their videos. Definitely go watch them. Nobody has reviewed two. I haven't seen anybody review a card merely thought of two. There's several channels that have reviewed one. And I would say go watch those. Go watch one and you'll get the gist of it. So check them out. The Magic Kit, definitely The Magic Kit. She's awesome. Definitely want to go check her out. And Unbiased Magic Review. David is awesome as well. His channel is super cool. Definitely go check him out also. All right, that's everything I can say about A Card Merely Thought of 2. You can find this at wondersandmysteries.com. Plus, you can also find this at penguinmagic.com. And I want to thank Maleem for allowing me to have this so that I could do the review for you. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye. Hey, and before I go, I just want to let you know that if you're looking for a friendly community made up of professional and amateur magicians just like yourself, be sure to check out the Magicians Forum at themagiciansforum.com. The Magicians Forum is helpful, clean, and you'll be able to ask questions and receive advice from people who know what they're talking about. Come see where masters like Harry Lorraine and Pop Hayden hang out. Oh, and of course, I'm there too. Looking forward to seeing you. Have a great week.